Welcome to Cox Presents, A Salute to Teachers, brought to you by Ashford University. This is the Music Machine.
Dream, we share the common heart for the American dream, where freedom, life, and liberty are shining like the sun, and each and every one can dream. Shadows crowd the dream, shining like a beam of light.
From San Diego's historic Balboa Theatre, Cox presents A Salute to Teachers, brought to you by Ashford University, the San Diego County Teacher of the Year Awards, celebrating the finest in education. Tonight's salute is produced in partnership with the San Diego County Office of Education and sponsored by Ashford University, Nothing Bundt Cakes, the USS Midway, San Diego County Credit Union, Procopio, and the Sequan Band of the Kumeyaay Nation. And now, she's an award-winning journalist with CNN's investigative and documentary units. He is a veteran broadcast journalist and has just retired as station manager at Channel 4 San Diego. Please welcome your hosts for this evening, Kira Phillips and Dennis Morgino.
Wow. A Okay, that's the best yet.
Yeah.
Yes.
All
thank
these years
you.
We've been doing this together, and
I know we hit it.
You
finally.
Guys win.
Thank you. Woo! All right. It was the free wine out front.
Yeah, that's right. Works every time. Listen, I am so happy to be back with all of you this year, and to be here again with my very good friend Kira. As we celebrate one of the things really that is right with the world.
Yeah, you know, we all watch the news every day and we see the global trouble spots multiplying and winging a lot of the joy from our daily lives, as we know. So it's so great to all be here and see everyone smiling and dressed in their finery tonight, because there is definitely a connection here.
Yeah, I mean, seriously, the way out of all this darkness is to do more of what you all do so well, opening young minds, finding that connection, inspiring hope and opportunity.
And sometimes we have to fight and even go to war, but there's been a lot less of that in the world, and there will be a lot less in this world if the first order of business is always to educate.
Yep, absolutely. We really believe that. You guys are incredibly important. What you do holds the key. So tonight, let's celebrate the example all of you set in your classrooms every day. We have a great show for you. We'll be right back to get started. Thanks for being here.
Do your children have what they need to succeed in school? Students with a computer and internet at home have a higher graduation rate than those without. And while more teachers assign homework online, having internet access at home is critical to the education and future of our youth. If your child is part of the National School Lunch Program and you have not had Cox Internet, you may qualify for the Connect to Compete program to get discounted internet service. Call 855-222-3252 or visit connecttocompete.org/cox to apply.
Stay with us. The first Teacher of the Year finalist will be announced next.
This is where my mom went to college.
This is where my mom got her degree.
My aunt did it here.
Here's where my dad did it.
Not here.
Not here.
Getting a college degree.
International business.
Marketing.
Accounting.
Healthcare.
It's a real accomplishment.
Classrooms come to you.
Here.
Right here.
This is my aunt.
My dad.
My grandfather.
Mom.
Go, Mom!
Technology changes everything.
Maybe even you.
You can trust me. I'm a kid.
I just love school all the time. I'm so excited. That's the reason I wake up in the morning.
Well, it's pretty fun because they have like lots of prizes that they give you if you're good, but then they get kind of mad if you're bad.
It's really fun, and I like my teacher because she does lots of decimals, and I really love decimals.
I like school because it's a fun place where we get to eat lunch and have snacks and play.
I like everything about school.
I love learning new things, learning any new things, reading things. I love writing. I love all the subjects. It's just exciting to learn new things, and I like making connections with teachers and friends, and I love being at school.
I like that they have pizza and they have other things that have cheese.
Like chemistry. Chemistry is science, kind of like science, so chemistry can go horribly wrong. But that's the fun thing about science. It can go horribly wrong. So it's lots of fun.
I love decimals. Who in this crowd loves decimals? Do you even, really?
You had to know that was coming.
That's true, they're teachers.
Yeah. All right, so obviously, there's a question written in here for us, but obviously, you are ready to get this party started and meet some inspiring teachers, right?
Well, our first presenter is the inspirational leader of an organization that has built a great partnership with San Diego's educational community over the past 10 years.
One of our good friends. Please welcome from the USS Midway Museum, retired U.S. Navy Admiral Mac McLaughlin.
Go Navy!
Wow, welcome to the Academy Awards for San Diego teachers this evening.
Goodness gracious. You know, nearly 70 years ago, Barbara Cox christened the USS Midway, beginning a partnership that continues to this day between the Midway, the James M. Cox Foundation, and San Diego's education community. In fact, our mission today is to educate and inspire future generations. And that's why we're proud to salute San Diego's educators tonight and serve as their community resource. And now, let's meet the first group of nominees.
Debbie Burton, Grossmont.
I teach AVID. It's an academic subject. It's an academic elective subject. But really, I teach students. I teach people how to be citizens of our society. And I think that's the most important role of a teacher is teaching students.
Ken Hirschman, San Diego.
Crawford is like the ultimate of America, perhaps you might say, as far as the melting pot. It's just this beautiful representation of our planet and just different ethnicities and blended into one. I have this real passion towards coming into an area like that and working with kids that kind of need that support and direction. And so for me, Crawford, you know, was the place that I wanted to go.
Aaron Duran, Escondido.
AVID is a program that helps support the students in terms of their academic needs, but also their emotional needs. And many times they don't feel successful. They don't believe that they can. They don't believe they can do Algebra 2, for example. They don't believe they can go to college. So our job is to make sure that they know how to communicate their fears, how to communicate what their goals are, and persevere through it.
Scott Huntley, San Dieguito.
It's really kind of an interesting bridge between my world history class and the cooking class, because in both classes I find myself talking about the other class. You know, when we're in world history and we're talking about the Russian Revolution and, you know, peace, land, and bread is the theme, or the French Revolution and they're talking about, you know, bread shortages, I can kind of talk about the importance of food to these societies and cultures. So it's really great.
And the first finalist for the San Diego County Teacher of the Year is, kind of getting in touch with my inner Brad Pitt at this point, thanks to all of you, Mr. Ken Hirschman.
Ken Hirschman teaches math at Crawford High School in San Diego. He feels called to help close the math achievement gap and builds confidence in students, showing them that if they can do math, they can do anything.
So these are kids that have only been in the country like for their first year. And so coming straight from areas of refugee camps and things like that and brand new to the country. But math tends to have a universal language, so these kids can perform just as high as anyone else. It doesn't matter where you're from, who you are, what your race is. If kids are given effective instruction and the right support, they can perform just as well as anyone. And so mathematics is really just the tool that I use to build self-belief in students, which I think kind of transcends through everything.
He's just a very good person, and it comes through, and kids, they feel that, and they know that even though, you know, maybe he's a little bit strict, he's strict for a reason, and they appreciate that because they can see every day that they're learning.
He just really wants, like, every single kid to succeed. And it's not necessarily that he wants them to, like, get the best test score, but, like, by the end of the year, if they believe in themselves and, like, they believe that they can succeed, like, that's his goal.
What I love most about my job is knowing that I'm making an impact on someone's life. There's nothing more rewarding to have a kid come back to me and thank me for the help that I gave them. And to me, that's just what keeps me going back and back and back. Hello, it's an honor, unbelievable honor for me to be standing here before you today. I'd like to thank my superintendent, Cindy Martin, who's sitting right here in front of me today. So I thank you so much. It's such an honor for me to be here today. my fellow colleagues, Carl Munn and also Jonathan Nguyen, who are just incredible teachers that it's been such an honor for me to work with. And it's the whole reason I'm here today, because I represent a team, my administration, my lovely wife, and you know, my family at home. You guys, it's just such an honor for me to be here today. So I thank you very much. Thank you.
One down.
Many more to go.
Many more to come. One of my favorite parts of this evening is being able to connect back with the teachers who were named Teachers of the Year at last year's show.
That's right, and throughout the evening, we will meet all five of the incredible women who have spent the past year representing San Diego County's 26,000 public school teachers.
They teach very different populations, but the constant among them is that they are all completely committed to helping their students succeed.
School has always been a place where lifelong friendships are born, as we know. And that's true for students and teachers, and apparently County Teachers of the Year as well.
The first teacher we'll meet tonight knows firsthand the impact teachers can have on a child's life.
She is driven to be a champion for her students and make her impact 100% positive.
Carrie Ariza suffered through a tough childhood. Perhaps from her past came her compassionate, energetic teaching style.
Froggy!
Going on now for 20 years.
I don't think that I can do what I need to do without having a really strong relationship with the kids. And they're the reason we're there.
Her ability to connect helped earn her the title County Teacher of the Year, and with it, many career highs.
The parents at my school are phenomenal. They literally made a red carpet from the office all the way down the hallway to my door.
She did a radio interview at KPRI alongside Dr. Randy Ward.
I'm sitting down with the county superintendent of schools in a little tiny room with all these buttons, and we're here to talk about education, and he is held in such high esteem, and here I am.
She and the others were honored by the Padres and in parades, and Ariza welcomed the chance to tour distinguished schools.
That was phenomenal. I don't think there's enough time in education where we actually get to get out of our classroom and get into the classrooms of other teachers.
She says the deep friendship that formed between this year's Teachers of the Year will continue long after they pass the baton to five new deserving colleagues.
This is going to give them a platform to speak about what's important to them. This is going to give them recognition that they've never had before.
For Poway's Carrie Ariza, mission accomplished.
And it has enriched my life in such a positive way, so I'm grateful for that.
Here she is, your 2014 San Diego County Teacher of the Year, Carrie Ariza.
Educators have one collective goal: to enable and empower success in students so that one day they proudly walk across the stage at their own high school graduation. Students arrive with different backgrounds, religions, life experiences, languages, and sometimes huge challenges to overcome. But our unifying commonality, what brings us together, is the unrelenting pursuit of education, and education equals choice in life. As teachers, we care and encourage students to reach their boundaries and to always soar beyond. Now, let's meet the next group of nominees.
Rebecca Carson, South Bay.
We want to give them a mindset of growth, the idea that we're always learning, no matter where we are. We're in a process of learning. And then they'll realize that they don't have to be perfect, and that every day is a new day. And then once they realize that, they realize their strengths, and then they go forward.
Jennifer Hamby, Oceanside.
Failure is an option. How you are going to persevere through that, how you are going to keep going and learn something from it, say, well, that didn't work. How can I change it and try again? Not that I don't do that every day, every hour of every day, of adjust and go on. And perseverance is a lesson that needs to be learned.
Crystal Ochoa, Poway.
I love that every day I wake up and I have the opportunity to influence a child, good or bad, and I have the opportunity to help them see and find their purpose. It's an awesome responsibility. I definitely don't take it lightly, but the thought of knowing that some kind word or some comment that I may say may affect them for the rest of their lives, you know, it's a big deal.
Stephanie Threet, Escondido.
Fourth graders are independent or growing in their independence, and they're curious and they're fun, and they're also learning and still practicing their scholarly behaviors and what it means to be responsible and to have all of their ducks in a row for their learning. I never get tired of teaching fourth grade. The conversations we get to have and the learning, the deeper level learning that they do, is just exciting every day.
The second finalist for San Diego County Teacher of the Year is Crystal Ochoa.
Crystal Ochoa is a resource specialist at Sunset Hills Elementary School in Poway. She's a champion for each of her students, building relationships of trust so they believe her when she tells them they can do it.
A resource specialist wears many hats, so I'm basically a resource for the entire school. I meet with all the teachers at all of the grade levels, and then what I can provide for them is just an additional boost of support. And sometimes that support's just encouragement. Other times it's that intense academic support that they need to help them in incorporating those skills in their general ed classrooms.
She brings out the best in every student. She's their biggest cheerleader. Crystal has a way of being honest with students, so there's no excuses. You know, they can't make any excuses, so she's very honest, but she does it in a sensitive way and just builds on their success.
A common misconception, I think, with special ed in general is that they can't change and that they can't grow. And the fact is that they can change and they can grow. Not in the same way and not on the same day, but they all can learn. And I think when you put in the appropriate and the proper steps, they can show that they are as capable as their general ed counterparts.
She's really taught me to be like a thinker, a reader, like to try to get it. And now I'm pretty much a whiz at math because I love it. I want to thank her for just being her.
Much. I'm so honored to be here. I work for an amazing district, Poway Unified Rocks. Thank you. I want to thank my principal, Tina Ziegler, who's here tonight, who's believed in me for the past 15 years and has seen in me things I didn't know that I had. And I love my school, Sunset Hills. I want to thank my family that's here, my husband, my twin sister who flew all the way from Indiana. Thank you so much. I am honored to receive this honor. Thank you so much.
They create calm when the world seems chaotic. They give with no strings attached. They stay until they get the results they desire. They are our teachers. Education is the backbone of our community, and for over 75 years, SDCCU is proud to support those who make our community a better place. Thank you, teachers. San Diego County Credit Union salutes you.
Stay with us. A salute to teachers. We'll be right back.
Remember when you were a kid? Little things meant a lot, like enjoying your favorite dessert or getting a smile from your favorite teacher. At Nothing Bundt Cakes, we remember these special moments too, and we enjoy celebrating them with you. Nothing Bundt Cakes is proud to support the 24th annual Salute to Teachers. Congratulations to all our teachers. And thank you for making growing up so much fun.
Tonight's salute is made possible by the generosity of these sponsors.
She is a very great teacher because she's always encouraging us. She tells us to never give up. She's always nice.
He has a very genuine attitude, and he genuinely cares for his students. And he makes sure to tell us that every day.
She was very fun with math, and actually she was so obsessed that her face got red with math, and her knees too.
She teaches us to persevere and never give up.
When you mess up, she gives you a second chance, but she tells you what you did wrong and how you can correct it.
She just tells us the funniest things ever, like with, if it's even a boring subject, she makes us laugh like crazily at it. And it's just really funny to have her be our teacher, and it's really fun too.
We aren't gonna be perfect, and she knows that, so that's why she doesn't yell if we make a mistake.
She takes us to lunch and recess.
She's so nice, fun to be around, kind, goofy, random, but she's very dedicated to her job.
She makes everything that you learn into a real experience, and she really cares about every single one of her kids, and you know high school kids can be crazy. But regardless of that, she loves each and every one of us.
Well, welcome back, everybody. At Cox Communications, we love putting on this show every year. And this year, we want the world to know about it.
That's right. So hold on just a second, because I'm just learning how to do this. Okay, guys, we're going to beat Ellen, and we're going to do a selfie. You guys ready? All right?
Let's go. Let's hear it.
Everybody stand up. All right. Okay, now everybody's got to retweet this. I'm going to send it out to the San Diego School District, okay? It's at CNN Kira, all right? And then we got to retweet, tweet. Am I saying all this right?
This is news to me.
Then Cindy Martin, be kind, be, dream big, okay? So we got to just do that hashtag salute and all that stuff. Do I sound old? We're gonna go big, I promise.
What does that make me?
But we don't do this alone, as you know. Yes. Let's continue. I'm gonna figure this out. We have many loyal, very loyal, actually, sponsors who are also dedicated to making a positive impact on teachers. And they're tweeting, too.
Yes. Our title sponsor has a particularly close relationship with teachers and learning because it's their business.
That's right. Please welcome Ashford University Provost, Dr. Lori Williams.
Successful, well-educated teachers help to create successful, well-educated students. All of us at Ashford University understand this direct correlation, and that's why we award master's degree scholarships to four deserving teachers in San Diego County. Let's take a look at this year's recipients.
Teachers teach, and those who truly excel keep learning.
It's a profession that requires us to stay on top at all times. And I think sometimes we get lackadaisical, and I don't want to be that person.
No fear of that, because Ashford University has awarded Melissa Cobian and three other county educators full scholarships in the area of technology.
Everybody can turn on an iPad, but actually making meaning of it and showing how to use an iPad for education is all the difference in the world.
Samuel Hess will earn a master's in arts in teaching and learning with technology worth about $20,000. The same with fourth grade teacher Stephen Keeley. He wants to create online classes for students who miss school.
I can create an environment where we can still stay in touch, where I create a portal where we can communicate, where I can post lessons, they post back. And I want to learn more about the dynamics behind that.
And Laurel Rice already trains teachers how to use 21st century strategies in the classroom. The scholarship gives her a greater resource of knowledge.
I get to communicate and learn from professors who are experts in this. And when that comes to me, I can then take that information and weave it into my own trainings that we're offering to the teachers in the district here, and that in turn trickles out to their students.
Ashford University is creating leaders in technology and education.
What better way to get a degree in technology than online with teachers from all around the country?
With our children's future in mind.
Please join me in congratulating our 2014 Ashford University Teacher Appreciation Scholarship winners. Next year, it could be you standing on stage as an Ashford Scholarship recipient. Tonight, I'm pleased to announce that our 2015 scholarship opportunity is now available. I'd like to invite all eligible teachers interested in pursuing an advanced degree to apply. You can find more information about this exciting opportunity in your program or at ashfordteacherappreciation.com. We can all attest to the profound impact teachers have when they truly care about their students. Teachers help build character and prepare students for the world. I'm honored to introduce the next group of nominees.
Jeannie Benowitz, Encinitas.
If you walk in my room on a Friday, sometimes I'm looking around saying, well, where shall I be? Because I have kids over here cooking, and I have kids over here packaging. I have kids at the computer printing business cards or printing labels. I have kids out in the 21st Century Pod area. They're writing and illustrating their book. It's this all, everyone's into their own thing and just bringing so much meaning to learning. And that's the best part, is that whole meaning to learning.
Pamela Barger, Del Mar.
What really excites me is seeing the connection again in the classroom. That's really my passion. If I can help them appreciate writing, if I can help them want to pick up that book and make it a lifelong learning experience and not just one that's going to happen when I'm in the classroom. Because I often say these are things you can take with you forever. It's not going to just happen in your fifth grade classroom.
Matt Filson, Ramona.
All students, when they enter the classroom, want to be successful. Whether they are or not is our job. If kids feel like a teacher cares about them and they're putting in time to help them succeed, it really pays off. And so the biggest thing in developing relationship with students is to really develop that sense of caring and let them know that you're there for their best interest and guide them toward developing as people.
Cheryl Lamb, Cajon Valley.
Fourth grade in my classroom is pretty fun. I set pretty high expectations, and my kids know that. Every day, we go above and beyond. We try to create this blended learning environment where my kids are thinking critically, they're working together in a group, they are being creative, and I'm trying to teach them that these skills will help them not just in these four walls of my classroom, but it's going to help them when they go into the real world and get a job and go to college.
Campette Pease, San Diego.
They always assume that in order to be successful, you have to not have grown up in this area. And so for them to see me and say, oh my gosh, you're successful and you grew up here and it means the world to me. Mm-hmm. And I love it when my students come back and they tell me about their successes.
The third finalist for San Diego County Teacher of the Year is Campette Pease.
Campette Pease teaches math, computers, and robotics at Wilson Middle School in San Diego. She focuses on acting as a role model for her students, providing access and opportunities that will help them achieve success.
I'm very passionate about STEM and science, technology, engineering, mathematics. So I think that enthusiasm that I have and my passion, it rubs off on them. I love how enthusiastic the kids are and how full of energy they are, and they're still so curious, and they learn through asking questions, they learn through exploring, problem solving. They have to persevere, they have to reiterate, because things don't always turn out the way they initially envisioned. So it's practice for everyday life and situations where you have to critically think and problem solve.
She really empowers kids to, like, you know, sort of take that learning to the next level. It's not just something that they're learning for the sake of learning. They're actually, you know, using it for real world situations. And she does that with such enthusiasm that it kind of becomes infectious, and you can't help but sort of get energized and inspired yourself when you see her in action.
I learned a lot of things from her, but one really important thing is to always give people your best and not just what you have left over. Because a lot of the time I find Miss Peace giving all of herself to her students.
Every morning I wake up excited. What new thing am I going to teach the kids? You know, what new strategy, what new ideas and activities are we going to do? And at the end of it, I just always feel so fulfilled. Like, I've made a difference. Yeah, I forgot my phone. I feel really, really honored to be here. And I want to thank everyone who's helped me on this journey, especially my family, my mom and dad, who babysit for me so I can stay those long hours and do the work that I do, my amazing husband who puts up with me, again, for the long hours that I work, the rest of my extended family up there, my amazing colleagues at Wilson Middle School, my principal, my superintendent, and lastly, my students. They mean the world to me, and they're the reason why I'm up here. So thank you.
Well, the next group of students here to entertain you actually won their way onto the show tonight.
Yeah, that's right. They won the talent competition at the Cox Back to School event in July.
And you are about to see why. Please welcome In Motion Dance Company.
In Motion. Very nice. Our next presenter is a County Teacher of the Year who knows the power of positive thinking.
Yes, and she knows that a positive approach takes deliberate effort, and that takes a lot of hard work.
Yeah, she also knows anything worth achieving is worth some hard work.
This one, the topic is donating limits for political campaigns.
Eileen Bagg Rizzo teaches English at Santana High. Since 2001, she's helped the school recover from an on-campus shooting that killed two students.
I think teachers kind of took a step back and learned to be more compassionate and caring. And we also increased the rigor in our school and the expectations at our school.
By winning a County Teacher of the Year title, Bagg Rizzo could build on the mission of growth and celebration.
This is a spotlight on what's right in public education, and there is a lot of it out there. So I think it's really important that people get that message and not just the negative things that they hear.
Ask what she's learned this year, and she'll say to aim high from tossing out the first pitch.
Because my family told me that if I bounced it, they would disown me.
To being a true representative of public education.
That whole idea of something positive out there. A lot of times, you get parents again and they start complaining, or students start complaining, or even teachers start complaining, and that spreads. But if people are saying positive things, I think that spreads as well.
Good job, give yourselves a hand.
Please welcome 2014 San Diego County Teacher of the Year, Eileen Bagg Rizzo.
For my first teaching position, my mom gave me a plaque that reads, "To teach is to touch a life forever." That plaque hangs in my classroom as a reminder of the awesome responsibility I have. For the past 25 years, I've seen education evolve. However, the one constant I've witnessed is the dedicated teachers who have a willingness to touch the lives of their students in a positive way. Our students may not remember every skill we teach them, but they will remember how a teacher made them feel. As Henry Adams once said, a teacher affects eternity. He can never tell where his influence stops. Now let's meet the next nominees.
John Beret, Grossmont.
I try to instill in my students the growth mindset and let them know that math is not genetic and that at any moment they can pick it up. That failure leads to success, and I try to inject some creativity, some humor, and just reassure them and let them know that at any moment they can become awesome at math.
Yael Bose, San Marcos.
The purpose of education really is to get and to develop lifelong learners and kids who want to continue learning beyond when they leave my classroom. So if they can develop that spark for learning and that desire, that's what I hope. I mean, they come to us with it in kindergarten, and somewhere along the line, a lot of them lose it. So if they can leave my class with that spark again, that would be awesome.
Ed Gillette, Sweetwater.
My background is in philosophy, and English to me it's not so much the structural aspects of teaching, grammar and so on, but it's argument and the ideas that are embodied in literature, and that's what I have fun introducing students to. A lot of what we have in our culture pushes kids to think superficially and to think quickly and to jump from idea to idea. And what I like about literature is that we slow down and start to reflect.
Jamie Rojas, San Diego.
It's just really beautiful to see how different kids from different neighborhoods interact when they have to work together on a project, or they have to solve a problem together, or they're trying to look at homelessness as not a problem to solve, but as a cause to fight for. And I think that's the beauty of being downtown in an urban setting, is that we are challenged with the problems that are right around us.
The fourth finalist for the San Diego County Teacher of the Year is John Beret.
John Beret teaches math at West Hills High School in Santee. He sees his role as part instructor, part motivational speaker, and impresses on his students why education and math will have a vital impact on the rest of their lives.
Many students come to my class, and for them, math is probably not their favorite subject. I let them in on the secret that education is important to their success, and math happens to be one of the classes in their arsenal of education. Students who proactively come up with solutions to problems that can be modeled by mathematics are 21st century critical thinkers. They're on the cutting edge of taking the content knowledge, and synthesizing it into the why.
One of the most exceptional things about John is his unbelievable ability to connect with kids. And when kids leave his class, they just have a different way of looking at the world and a more positive way of looking at the world. And he is, in every respect, a life changer for a lot of these kids.
Thank you so much for believing in my goals. Thank you for believing in me to have that constant reminder that somebody has my back no matter what. So I think I'd thank him for always being that support and that mentor I can look back on and kind of model what I should do off of his success.
Thank you. Wow, what a moment. I'm blessed to be among all these talented educators, first off. And I would not be 3/7 the teacher I am today without the love and support of my family and friends. Thank you. Especially from my beautiful and amazing wife, Michelle, and our twins who are at home, Sophie and Noah. I can't wait to show you this. Thank you very much.
At Cox Communications, we're not just giving back. We're investing in our future by opening doors of opportunity and expanding the learning potential for thousands of students. For decades, Cox and the Cox Cares Foundation have supported education throughout Southern California through scholarships, nonprofit grants to help educate children, support for our teachers, and by providing computers and internet access to students and families. For more information on Cox's community involvement, visit cox-cares.org.
How will you know? Where in the universe? Why in the world? What's under the surface? Why does it explode? How does it shake? What is its nature? Why does it rain? What does it create? Who really needs it? How does it fly? How will you know? ITV. Now you know. ITV.
In 1945, Navy widow Barbara Cox christened the USS Midway, which served America for 47 years. Today, 45,000 students a year participate in field trips and educational programs through Midway University. USS Midway Museum salutes Cox Communications and the James M. Cox Foundation for a $1.5 million grant to expand Midway's educational programs as they build a bridge between the greatest generation and America's future generations.
I learned that confidence just comes with doing and trying and failing and trying again until you get it right.
I learned that it's perfectly acceptable to do things your own way and have confidence in that.
If somebody's mad at you, don't make them more mad. Say sorry.
Whatever you want to do is possible, and you can make a difference in your community if you just set your mind to it.
Whatever you're doing, however small it is, no matter what, it will build up and it will make a difference. Every little thing counts.
Probably how to forgive and to give other people second chances.
You have to be able to work with different people, work with anyone you don't know, maybe someone you don't like. You have to communicate with them good.
Probably if you mess up, try again.
To believe in myself, to never give up on my goals.
We learn to read and we learn to count.
If you don't pay attention really good to like your friends and stuff like that, bad things are gonna happen.
Well, let's see. There is DTOP for like don't touch other people, and the most important is like don't hurt, punch, kick, kind of like DTOP again, but just don't be mean and be at school with heart.
Probably how to read, because if you're driving, you see a sign, it says danger ahead, you read that, you look at that sign, and you wouldn't know words. So what are you supposed to do?
Don't punch, hit, or kick.
That's the best part. That's good. He's learning discipline.
Yeah, right. So how are you enjoying the show so far?
You're tweeting, hashtagging, all of that, right? Okay.
It's bouncing around the world, we hear.
I'm checking my phone. Yes, yeah. We've already gone global. Yeah. All right, well, I think so far definitely tonight has been pretty sweet.
Ah, I see. Oh, a segue. Our next presenter knows a little something about sweets.
That's right. And if there was a Cake of the Year award, she would definitely take home that prize.
Yes. Please welcome from Nothing Bundt Cakes, Mara Fortin.
Each one of us here has a memory of at least one teacher who believed in us and made us feel that we could do anything. Nothing Bundt Cakes proudly stands behind those teachers who make each and every day a mission field of lifting up our future leaders, one child at a time. Nothing Bundt Cakes and myself, as a mother of two young girls and a Mount Carmel High grad, is honored to show you the next group of nominees.
Beth Sanford, Mountain Empire.
I think it's really important that we empower children to feel comfortable with being able to make a mistake. And so often we stress that there's a right and a wrong, and we don't allow for do-overs or being able to go back and change an answer or think about it in a different way. And I think that the way I try to teach the children in my class is that I want them to get messy. I want them to experience the problem, and it might be hard, and that's okay because there are a lot of things in life that are hard.
Joe Kemmery, Santee.
It's so easy to look at it as Mr. Kemmery's class of fourth graders, but I look at them as I've got 32 students in my class, and each one of them has a unique strength and a unique weakness. And so as I'm planning my year in every lesson, I'm not looking for how am I getting my group. It's how can I use those strengths to help improve everybody? How can I build on those weaknesses and really improve them? And it's just kind of, it's differentiating in a way that I'm looking at each child as the child and not just as my class of fourth graders.
Sarah Songer, Valley Center, Palma.
One thing I just always tell them is to do your personal best. And I think that if you are always doing your personal best, whether you're struggling in an area or it's something you excel in, you still need to do your personal best. You put in all of your effort, you extend your learning, and use whatever resources are around, but do your personal best, always.
Maria Turan Cruz, Carlsbad.
They know that Mrs. Cruz understands where they're coming from. That I have the empathy, but I also have the expectation. I know what it takes, and I want to take them there because I know they can. So I tell them stories of the war, what we had to do to be out. I tell them how grateful and how blessed we are to be in this country, because when you come from that to the freedom that we have here, the gift is priceless. So all those stories are in my classroom with my students.
Sarah Church, San Diego.
Well, the Green Team is something that was created almost 4 years ago, and we explore environmental ecology problems that are happening on campus or in the city or in the world, and then you try to think of practical solutions to solve these problems. And it's really wonderful to see that they're 8 years old, but they're thinking like adults. We're partners with the San Diego Zoo's ecology team, and we also work with the City of San Diego, their environmental department. So, they really get out there and try to think about bigger issues than just what's going on in third grade, which is important.
And the fifth finalist for San Diego County Teacher of the Year is Maria Turan Cruz.
Maria Turan Cruz teaches fourth grade at Jefferson Elementary School in Carlsbad. She expects the best from her students all the time and strives to instill values of honesty, integrity, and hard work, which she knows will help them succeed in fourth grade and in life.
I think that the most important thing that I teach my students is hard work. It's what it takes to accomplish any goal. It's not your set of skills, which are important, but it's that work ethic that will make you persevere, that will make you do 100% of your best every day and all the time.
We talk about giving your best effort every day and all the time and how success equals hard work, and she personifies that. You know, she was at the top of her class in her home country. She came here and literally had to start all over. Not only started all over, but graduated, became a doctor, decided that teaching was her passion, went back and did that, and has been very successful. So I think that that story serves as that inspiration where we can say kids work hard, because this is what you can accomplish in the form of Mrs. Cruz.
There is that possibility, not only for my students to see this, but for the parents, that they can relate to that, that they can say, my daughter can be accomplished just like she is. It's that role model that I take very seriously, because I know that that's what they will need to be able to succeed in this country.
When you have Mrs. Cruz as your teacher, school is always something to look forward to because it's filled with fun. And I look up to Mrs. Cruz because she's very smart and she works hard, and that's what I want to do.
The learning never stops. And so between the lifelong learning and the hard work, you can accomplish the impossible.
We did it! I have to tell you, this honor belongs to an entire community. It belongs to Carlsbad, but specifically to Jefferson Elementary. To my sisters in the trenches, Christy, Ray, Eileen, to my principal who's desperately trying to teach me how to breathe. To my Jefferson parents who, without them, we wouldn't be here. And especially to my little ones. Those little ones is what make the teacher that I am. To the Turan and the Cruises, thank you for your unshakable faith in me. I love you. This is such an honor. It belongs to all of us. Thank you.
It belongs to all of us. That's right.
Definitely some remarkable stories in this theater tonight.
Yes, indeed. And as the mother of two small children, 3.5-year-old twins, it's pretty reassuring to see so many incredible teachers dedicating their lives to making a better community and fantastic children.
Yeah, I agree. Our next presenter represents an organization that realizes being a good community partner is just good business.
From San Diego County Credit Union, please welcome Nathan Schmidt.
San Diego County Credit Union would like to salute all the teachers who dedicate their time and talent to educating the next generation. Your influence on students doesn't end in the classroom and will impact young lives in ways you may never know. It's my pleasure to introduce a talented educator whose creativity makes mathematics come alive for her students.
Texas Rangers, please come up. Cubs.
The stats of pro baseball teams rest in the hands of seventh graders at Hilltop Middle School.
Their homework this coming week is to write a letter to a Major League Baseball manager, and they're going to talk about evaluating their players and how the upcoming season's going to be.
Their teacher, Melissa O'Donohue, turns them loose on real-life scenarios. If not baseball, then world hunger and microlending.
Simple and compound interest in kids get to actually learn how that works in helping underdeveloped countries and helping their economy.
That math with a purpose approach and her ability to reach 180 students a day earned O'Donohue the title San Diego County Credit Union Math Educator of the Year.
If I feel like I missed any kids and I don't acknowledge them, then I feel like it's a wasted day. So I really make sure I make those personal connections with the students.
Her goal? get students fluent in the mathematics that matter in life.
Your data has to be accurate, right?
Congratulations, Melissa. On behalf of San Diego County Credit Union, I'd like to present you with this award as well as a $1,000 grant.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you, San Diego County Credit Union and Cox Communications, for this very generous gift. I'd also like to thank my mentor and role model, my father, for teaching me to value education and live a life of service. Educators, let's continue to make mathematics meaningful and accessible to all of our students. Thank you very much.
I needed her as my math teacher.
$1,000, even I can do that math. You know, and the funny thing about that whole segment was that the tape of the math class actually looked fun. Can't believe I'd be saying that.
Let's clap for math, shall we? That is the truth. Yeah. Well, every teacher that you will meet tonight, no doubt, has his or her own secret formula, as we know, for helping kids learn.
Our next presenter says her secret to successful teaching is a four-letter word.
That word is P-L-A-Y.
Oh.
Play.
Bethany Chaffin.
Now, does Corny bite?
No, not at all.
Is part zookeeper, part theater director.
Go arrest him.
She's a professional playmate who tirelessly meets students where and how they love to learn.
It's what they need in order to be able to process things, where I can introduce a topic to them, but until they've actually experienced it, manipulated it, played with it, they really don't understand it.
Her 14 years of research and use of play-based learning earned her the title County Teacher of the Year.
Very humbling through the whole process.
New title, new role. Chaffin found herself involved within the Escondido Union School District, driving new projects.
That's one way that the title has really helped, because when I present to the board as a County Teacher of the Year, that's been an amazing thing for them to kind of just perk up and listen.
And the title literally opened doors with the opportunity to tour state distinguished schools.
Had a lot of conversations with my principal about how, oh, look, I want to show you this and how they did this, and do you think we can try this at our school? And so that was incredible.
And then there's the team of five women and all they became professionally and personally.
And we've done spa days and gone and got our nails done, and yeah, it's been
a once-in-a-lifetime journey ends with lifelong friends and some advice for the new five.
To take a deep breath in the beginning and to know that they do deserve this, that they were selected for a reason.
That, and remember to play.
Awesome, okay.
Please welcome 2014 County Teacher of the Year, Bethany Chaffin.
Yay! A teacher is someone who needs to be playful, imaginative, motivating, inspiring, and magical. Yes, magical. There is no other way to describe how a teacher can change a child's life. A type of magic that teaches our young ones to have a growth mindset, that it's okay to not know something yet. I stand before you proud tonight to represent all of the magic you all work in your classrooms. The job of a teacher is not one that just anyone can do. Only the most magical people can be teachers. Now, let's meet the next group of our magical nominees.
Megan Leach, Fallbrook.
You know, research shows that play can help with working things out with critical thinking. It can have students stop and think about their actions, their consequences. They get to imagine, they get to pretend, and all of that leads to language. You know, it takes everything, and if we can go down the steps and start to teach in transitional kindergarten, they will be more ready and more prepared as they go up.
Natalia Morales, National.
More than anything, I love seeing those little faces ready to learn. I love bringing new things for them, and they're so excited about something they've never done. As a teacher, you're setting the foundation for them to become lifelong learners. So then I think it's important for them to really have that joy and get it from early on.
Stephanie Martin, Poway.
I think this is their first real school experience for most of them in a public school education, and I have the chance to lay that foundation for them so they realize the expectations, the structure of school, that they know there's a time to laugh and play and there's a time to buckle down and work hard. And they leave my classroom knowing there's a balance, and a lot of our day seems like play to them, but it's very focused instruction.
Karen Stewart, Hamul Del Zura.
There's so much to kindergarten, and I've had people who have said, oh, you teach kindergarten, that's just like babysitting, but it's not. There is so much groundwork there, but also in kindergarten, they're learning how to get along and how to cooperate. They're learning big words like respect and integrity. They know what that means to do the right thing when no one's looking. And so there's so much to that that's so important. And the sixth finalist for San Diego County Teacher of the Year is, drum roll please. If I can get it out. Ready? Stephanie Martin!
Stephanie Martin teaches transitional kindergarten at Willow Grove Elementary School in Poway. She knows that while her students are small, their potential is huge, and she strives to help each of them achieve it.
I love that transitional kindergarten is ground zero. I love that the clay is wet, and they come in and they're fresh and they're excited and they want to be there. They want to learn. Their young age and stature really doesn't deter them from thinking at higher levels. I assess every student to stay on the cutting edge of his or her learning. So students that are ready to write, they are writing. And students that are ready to read, they are reading. It's amazing what these kids can do.
Stephanie has just an incredible connection with her students. She cares about them very, very deeply, and they know it. Her ability to assess kids and just know where they are on a continual basis is simply amazing. She knows where they are and where she wants them to go, and she's just incredible with them.
I said to her that she's the best teacher ever because she says nice words to me.
I want them to know that they've got words to use and they've got actions that they can take. I want them to strive for more and more and more to be the best that they can be. I want them to challenge themselves. I want them to always know that I'm here for them too. Always.
What an incredible honor, incredible honor. I have so many people to thank. My husband, Jeff, who I definitely married up when I married him. Our three boys, Tanner, Gunner, and Connor, you men make me a better person. I have to thank all of my friends and family, my brother Scott, who I adore, my dad, and my family at Willow Grove. Crazy mad love for all you women, Karen Bayrow, Heather Smith, Mandy Bedard, Kelly McGill, and my fabulous principal, Amy Huff. You are solid, Amy. I love our school board. I thank my school district. I couldn't work for a better district. And I especially share this with my students, past and present, and their parents. Working with you is incredible. It makes my job so happy and fun every day. I share this with all of you. Thank you.
There are more than 10,000 students graduating this weekend from Ashford University. How many of you are parents? How many graduates are parents? Raise your hand. Look at that.
Please don't buy into the lie that the world's gonna sell you. You're not ordinary. There is no ordinary citizen like you. They're telling you that extraordinary is someone else. What makes you extraordinary is the day in and the day out. What you've done for 4 years, what you've done out there with children, with a family, and then putting it into your extra time, this is extraordinary. Ordinary people don't do that. What gift do you have? One, you've got a college education now. You are educated, you are powerful, you're among the elite of the world. You're extraordinary and you're qualified. You are qualified to go out there and do something great.
Study a lot.
A lot.
She had to do so much homework.
They just couldn't believe my mind.
Go, Mom!
I want to go to college because I want to grow up and be a scientist.
I want to be a teacher like Mommy.
Congratulations, Grandma.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Go, Mom!
All along, it's been about showing them that it's never too late to achieve your dreams. And I think it's important that they're here to see it and to witness that we've done it.
Go, Mom!
Stay tuned. Some of San Diego's finest young musical talent coming up next.
In a city of innovation, why are so few law firms innovative? Procopio, San Diego's largest law firm, understands innovation. With a business model that makes sense, Procopio attracts superior talent from large global firms and provides the platform to handle matters of any size, anywhere in the world. The result? Top-tier service at an unusually cost-effective price point. Find out what some of San Diego's most successful companies already know. Check out Procopio and do better for your business.
Bullying isn't just limited to schools.
Such a loser.
It follows your kids everywhere. It's easy for your child to become a target, and easier online. Check your kids' online activity and talk to them about cyberbullying. There's no hiding behind the words they type or the images they post. To learn more, visit smartcyberchoices.org. Calling all parents, in partnership with the San Diego Police Foundation Safety Net Program, sponsored by ESET and Cox Communications.
Well, they unselfishly give back to others. They get up every morning, you know, to... not for themselves, but for others, for us to help educate us in ways we didn't think we could be educated on.
Because they really help you learn if you don't know anything. Because they help you, they keep you safe. They never let somebody hurt you.
You know, they dedicate their whole lives to making people become the best that they can be.
There are these people in a great position of power that, like, you know, they help students with everything, get prepared for everything in the world, and I think they definitely deserve a lot more recognition than they get.
Well, none of them ever yell to you. They just tell you nicely, give you a warning, but luckily I'm a good student, so I never get yelled at.
Being a hero is not having superpowers and being like Superman. It's just being nice, having a heart, being bold in your own way.
If there were no teachers, no one would know anything, and there would just be wreaking havoc all over the world, and the world could get destroyed. Yeah.
Wreaking havoc all over the world.
See, that kid agrees with me.
Well, speaking of all over the world, oh, okay. Guys, check out our selfie. Can we bring it up? Where is it? Yeah. We're trending. We are trending. And where's my Poway Unified peeps?
Oh, yeah.
Big reason why we're trending. All right, where's my Sweetwater peeps?
Up front.
San Diego Unified.
Cindy.
All right, to all you other peeps, you better get on it, because those are the only three that I see making this trend, okay? Hashtag salute. Here we go.
Our next performer recently won the San Diego Symphony's Young Artist Competition.
And I think once you hear her play, you will understand why she was named the 2014 Hotshot.
She is fantastic. Please welcome from La Jolla High School, Hazel Friedman. Hazel Friedman.
That is exactly why we have to keep the arts alive in our school system.
Yeah. Wasn't she fantastic?
Well, this next returning Teacher of the Year believes that life is all about relationships.
Well, she takes that philosophy throughout her life and especially into her classroom.
Cindy Jackson prefers to look her middle school students in the eye.
They need to feel safe in your classroom before any learning can happen. And no matter how kids behave or what they do, you constantly need to keep that respect and that love.
She knows the value of truly trusting someone.
I had teachers that I think literally saved my life and knew how hard my home life was.
She's become one of those teachers, and the title County Teacher of the Year gave her a voice on behalf of children and gifted her with a treasured support system.
It's like a sisterhood. I haven't really known how to have fun in my life, so these girls have brought fun to my life.
Jackson was also a finalist for California Teacher of the Year. She says, what you see is what you get.
I just teach out of love and relationships, and whether it's with my kids or my colleagues, and that's really what brings the whole picture together.
An approach worthy of accolades, but her granddaughter, who's six, had a question.
She knew I got a trophy, so she says, Grandma, does this mean you're a trophy wife?
Please welcome San Diego County and finalist for California Teacher of the Year, Cindy Jackson.
Thank you. Teaching is for the brave, the risk takers. It is for those who make themselves vulnerable and carry love in our hearts. Teachers save lives, and that might sound cliche, but for me it's real, and I know that I'm not alone. Bravo to all of you who create that safe haven and community of trust. Sometimes we don't see our impact until after our students leave our four walls. But when they do, reluctantly leave our rooms at the end of the year, we all know they never really leave. They're right here in our hearts forever. Now let's meet the next group of nominees.
Tina Meglich, Escondido.
I believe that every single person has a strength and that we need to really just, it's our job to uncover that strength and develop that strength and build from that. We all come to the table with different strengths, and we need to provide opportunities for that learning to happen. And so if my students can believe that and that's their takeaway from my class, then I know that they're going to be okay once they leave.
Melanie Nance, Oceanside.
It's a great advantage for anyone. I can't think of a single person I know that wouldn't like to wake up one morning and be able to speak Mandarin or speak Spanish. It's a great advantage. All of the studies have shown that children that do speak a second language develop a portion of their brain and exceed students in mathematics and science and reading, even in English.
Loriana Leoncavallo, Bonzel.
We help students become the best version of themselves. Because our students, academically, they're amazing. You know, it's them interacting with the environment around them, interacting with adults, interacting with peers, understanding how to navigate that, and that's what we really do. It's about being reasonable, it's being flexible, and it's being able to see different perspectives. And we focus on that. That's huge for us.
Helen Kieran, Sweetwater.
So they can never say, oh, I don't have a babysitter, I can't come to school. No, no, you bring your baby. Your baby's part of this program. We want your baby here. And then they get to be here and see their baby interact with other babies and get to actually share experiences with other girls. The older girls help the younger girls, and it's very rewarding to see this happen.
The seventh finalist for San Diego County Teacher of the Year is Helen Kieran.
Helen Kieran teaches the Teen Parent Program in the Sweetwater Union High School District. She focuses on finding each of her students' alternate pathways to success on their journey to graduation.
Well, my students are all pregnant or parenting. And the way my program works is we are divided into two blocks. The pregnant girls work on their academics first, and the mothers stay with their babies. After that block, they switch, and every pregnant girl is assigned a baby, so the mothers get to go work on their academics. And we're like a little family, and the girls are, they're like a sisterhood, and they help each other out, but there's something about seeing a young lady graduate with her diploma in one hand and her baby in the other and say, I did it, because it's heartwarming, I can't tell you.
You believe her because she's so genuine. She's so sincere. And when she looks at you and says, you know what? You can do this. You believe you can. And then she provides the pathway and ensures that they can.
If my program wasn't there, many of these girls would not graduate from high school because they would have nowhere to go. And I want them to be good role models. You know, they have these children that are going to be continue to learn from anything that I've taught this girl. So it really is touching the future.
More than just a teacher, she's more like a heaven-sent angel for me, and I could just never thank her enough for all that she's done for me and my daughter. She didn't just see me as like, oh, that troublemaker, you know. She saw me as a student who needed help, and she wasn't going to stop until she made her imprint.
This is such an honor. Thank you so much. I first off want to start by thanking God, because if there's anything good in me, it comes from Him, and I give Him the credit and the glory. I also want to say that I'm so proud to be standing with all these fine honorees. I'd like to recognize my colleagues, my administration, and my co-workers of the Sweetwater Union High School District. I love working with you all, especially those of you in alternative education who work with kids on the fringe. I also want to thank my family and my friends. Many of you are here tonight. Thank you for loving me and supporting me on this journey. And I also want to thank my students, because you give me my purpose. Thank you, everybody.
Fantastic story.
Something pretty special about that woman.
Yeah. Our next presenter is representing a group with a very long history in San Diego and a well-deserved reputation for giving back to the community.
That's right. They have also supported this event for many, many years because they know that a strong educational community means a brighter future for all of us.
Please welcome, on behalf of the Sequan Band of the Kumeyaay Nation, Maria McRoberts.
Good evening. Teachers are more important than ever. Every day they work to inspire our children, to enrich their lives with knowledge, and to shape them to become responsible leaders of tomorrow. Sequan is honored to pay tribute to the group of men and women who proudly call themselves teachers. Now, let's meet the next group of nominees.
Monica Rainville, Solana Beach.
What I love what technology has brought to my students is the ability to collaborate with one another and learn how to communicate with one another. They're thinking very critically now, and they're being so much more creative than we could have ever done with pencil and paper. And they're sharing their ideas and their creativity with others, and then they're learning from each other. And that's much more than I can even provide.
Jesse Schuweiler, Fallbrook.
It's all about finding a connection with the students, making it relevant to them. Getting students to read is a challenge. To enjoy reading is even more challenging. But again, finding that connection, getting that hook for them is a key component. It's all about finding some kind of connection for them.
Mike Bird, Poway.
I'm not embarrassed about this, but Mr. Bird, the science nerd, it makes sense, and I am a self-proclaimed science nerd. I love it. I love geoscience. I love studying volcanoes and earthquakes and seeing how things, you know, interact, and astronomy, and just a full moon, and just how beautiful that is, and our sunset. And I want them thinking outside the classroom and seeing stuff that we're talking about in the real world.
Maricela Lozano, San Isidro.
I tell my students that I arrive each day with this gift, and it's something new that I want to teach them, and it's their choice to accept it or not to accept it. And if they don't choose to accept it that day, that is fine. I return the following day with the same gift and offer it again. And many do take the opportunity to learn. And to see the growth in children is just amazing, just amazing.
All right, the eighth finalist for San Diego County Teacher of the Year is Jesse Schuweiler.
Jesse Schuweiler teaches 11th grade English and AVID at Fallbrook High School. He knows English can encompass many subjects and uses all angles to steer his students onto a path toward success.
Teaching is an art form. We're not robots, and if we were, I mean, it would be a kind of a scary environment, in my opinion. I teach ELD, and obviously there's many challenges with teaching a population that struggles with acquiring the language. But the beauty of teaching ELD is being able to use, for example, taking a lesson in biology and incorporating that into acquiring academic vocabulary, writing a summary about it. So that's where I like to bring in other subjects.
When one walks into his room, one knows that the students are serious about learning. He's a popular teacher, but they also know that he means business. He's very firm, and they learn quickly that they can go to him and talk to him and know that he'll support them and help them.
He's always made me feel really important, and like all of my goals are legitimate and really cool things to strive for, and so I have always appreciated the fact that he's always there to talk to, and that's something that's been special through high school for me.
When you see the light bulb go on and you know that you maybe had a small piece of that, I think that's a great thing. Wow. Thank you so much. It's truly an honor to be standing in front of you in a room full of so many amazing educators. And I have to thank my wife for being my rock, the love of my life. Thank you so much. I truly believe that we have the best profession in the world. It's all about the kids. And it is such an honor to be with them every single day. And I know you guys know that. So thank you very much.
So, this is international business. It's very complicated stuff.
That was my major.
There are concerns about your readiness.
Well, your overseas operation is giving you standard currency risk exposure issues. Your internal processes aren't in line with the most current regulatory standards, and your CFO is learning Mandarin when he should be learning Cantonese.
The Forbes School of Business at Ashford University.
When can you start?
Monday.
Stay tuned. The last two Teacher of the Year finalists will be revealed when we come back.
Now hear this, San Diego. The USS Midway is celebrating its 10th anniversary, and we can't wait to show you what makes Midway the top-rated attraction in San Diego.
As a Midway volunteer, we see how much San Diego supports Midway. So for a limited time, San Diegans can buy adult admissions for only $10.
And we'll see you aboard Midway.
The USS Midway is proud to support the 24th annual Salute to Teachers and thanks all the teachers in our county for their dedication.
Tonight's salute is made possible by the generosity of these sponsors.
I think it's important to get an education because we're all like together in this huge system and we all need to work together to like better our society.
Because if you don't go to school, then you
your parents will go to jail. So if there wasn't any school, then everyone would have to go to jail, technically.
Teachers are important because without them, we really wouldn't have as much guidance. They're really the ringleaders, and they tell us what to do, and that may sound really normal, but that's what they're there for. They're there to guide us and take us along a path so that one day we can teach others.
When you grow up, you have to stay with that education. You can't just be like, oh, I learned this, but now I'm just going to cast it away because I don't need it anymore. It's pretty much education is preparing you for growing up and getting a job and all that stuff.
If you don't go to school, when I was younger, I said, oh, I don't want to go to school today. But then I realize now, if you don't go to school, then you won't know anything.
If we didn't have education, then we would still be caveman. We wouldn't have TV. We wouldn't have electricity. We wouldn't have scientists. We practically wouldn't have brains. We just growl, mumble, and hit stuff.
I think that teachers are important because they always help us learn, and if we didn't have them, we all wouldn't be smart. We need teachers.
They get better every year, don't they? Well, welcome back. You know, we've talked a lot over the years about how Kira grew up here and went to school and all the great teachers who supported her.
That's right, and I love to do this every year, recognize my high school journalism teacher, Jessica Patton, who has inspired me for 30 years now. She keeps looking younger, I get older.
You look great, Jessica.
Love you, Jess.
Last year, though, we really thought we'd hit the jackpot. I mean, you know, all these Kira stories. We get all the Kira stories every year.
It's my hometown.
Yeah, but, you know, we thought, I need to see some proof. One of her best friends got a rather big promotion last year. You might have heard about this.
That is right. Yeah. She was my next-door neighbor growing up and was named superintendent of San Diego Unified. Cindy Martin, take a bow.
Stand up, please.
She's an amazing woman. I can tell you, I've known her since we were 10.
Now, wait. Keep standing. They both promised us that they had this great picture of Kira helping Cindy getting ready for her prom, right? So night of the show comes last year. Oh, shucks, we can't find it. But Cindy found it. First thing Sunday morning. You thought we'd forget, didn't you? Get a load of this hair, folks.
Oh, yeah. It's a very good thing that we're not on social media. Being able to text and do video, it wouldn't have been good. We had fun as teenagers, and at 12, of course.
It's there now.
Yes, it is. It is out there.
That was worth the wait, though, wasn't it?
Love you, Cindy. All right. Well, moving on, our next presenter is from a local company that is committed to being a dedicated member of the San Diego community.
They know that corporate success and a thriving community go hand in hand. From Procopio, please welcome John Lorman.
Good evening. Each generation measures the progress of learning in regards to a baseline. And what we learn when we are young establishes the foundation for the future growth. When we expand that foundation by our desire to learn, we acquire knowledge continuously. The teacher who can instill a never-ending desire to learn or enthusiasm is one that allows each generation to move that baseline forward to a higher level. Now, let's meet the next group of nominees.
Michael Bruce, La Mesa, Spring Valley.
I would argue that there is a reason all of us are here, and we're all, each and every one of us, unique among the billions of people who've lived. What's your purpose? Why are you here? Maybe we can find it. Maybe we can find a skill that you didn't know you had. Maybe you can learn a skill in math or science or history. Maybe we can start a fire for your dream or your ambition. So it's powerful.
Mary Goins, Lakeside.
I want them to have a confidence that they didn't have maybe when they first came in that they can do this thing we call art, which by the time they get to middle school sometimes is really scary. But they can do, they can create, and they can show to other people. That's risk-taking. And that's what I think one of the big things that the art experience gives to students.
Dennis Gildahouse, San Diego.
I'm really big on students being active in any activity, whether it be band or whether it be the key club or whether it be choir. I'm such a big proponent of encouraging my students, if you're not going to play sports, you need to be involved with something else. You need to be a part of a group, because I just feel that it makes their experience in education just so much better.
Amy Cruz, Sweetwater.
I think they get to learn that when you really work at something, and you persevere, and you practice, and you try your best, that there's always a good result. And it, again, it may not be that you have the solo, or that you're the best player in the room, but that you accomplished and you conquered that challenge. You got over that hurdle and were able to be part of something that's bigger than yourself.
The ninth finalist for the San Diego County Teacher of the Year is Mary Goins.
Mary Goins teaches visual art at Lakeside Middle School. She knows that experience with the arts is a vital part of creating productive, creative, problem-solving citizens for the future.
The art studio is a very unique learning environment. As soon as they come in the door, I address them as artists. I don't call them students. I don't call my classroom room 7. We call it the art studio. And if you want to get your hands dirty, that's what we do. They learn to make their own decisions along the way. And they learn that there's never always just one answer in the art studio. And I think in the process of trying different things and having some failure along the way, because that happens, you know, it just does. Not everything you attempt turns out, but that's life. And that's the same in math, it's the same in language arts, and I weave all of those subjects in.
She is an artist in teaching. She is an artist in humankind, of treating each other. She has this art of always reaching out to touch children's creativity, and that's why it makes her such an important part of our team.
I love the fact that she takes the time to help us if we need it, and there is no right or wrong way to do it.
It's about them finding their own way, but I poke along the way. And so it's about watching them grow.
Well, I think, honestly, honor is not the right word. I don't even know what the honor is or what the word is, but three just big shout outs to my district and my administration for knowing that art is not only important, it's critical, all of the arts, for all of our students to become these well-rounded individuals. And my staff for allowing me to wear my Converse tonight. You guys rock it, okay? You just do. You're a great team to work with. And then my family and my friends, they know I work hard, and they make sure that I play hard, which keeps me motivated in the classroom. So thank you.
Hey, Mary. Mary. Oh, did you guys notice she had a pencil skirt on? That's what those colors were. They were pencils, the ultimate pencil skirt.
Is that what they mean by pencil skirt?
Yes, I think so. Now I do.
See, I learn something new every day.
I had to take a picture of her. I'm going to tweet it. Don't forget, guys, hashtag salute, all right? All right, well, it's great to see that there are still some arts programs alive and well in the San Diego County. I've said that all night, by the way.
Definitely. These next performers are using their school's art program to push their talent to new levels.
Please welcome the Mount Carmel High School dance troupe.
Yeah.
Did you see that look? They all at the same time went like this. They've got it.
I think they were supposed to do that.
Oh, yeah. I thought it was some serious toot. I love it. love it.
This next returning County Teacher of the Year practices what she preaches.
That's right. You can see it in the connections that she makes with all of her students.
Crystal Reinick teaches high school English, language, and composition. She has a unique rapport with students.
Turn around.
And a goofy side they love. Last year, she not only won County Teacher of the Year, but was a finalist for California Teacher of the Year.
It was really overwhelming. I think I've overused two words this past year, overwhelming and inspiring.
Reinick's teaching philosophy centers around two ideas. First, that teachers provide much-needed human connection.
We are the ones that connect them with each other. We connect them with the curriculum. We connect them with history. We connect them with the rest of the world.
And then she emphasizes the emotional part of connecting.
Teachers need to care. And it seems so simple. But students know if a teacher cares or doesn't care. And it is a big deal.
She cherishes the caring, carefree relationship with the other four.
They've made me not just a better teacher, but a better person.
Reinick has taken the job of County Teacher of the Year very seriously. And she tells future winners, it's really not about you.
You are a representative now, and you have a voice. Use it so that people see how important education is and how important teachers are and you know, how much we give and how much we care.
Please welcome 2014 San Diego County and finalist for California Teacher of the Year and winner of tonight's Best Kira's Dress Lookalike, Crystal Reinick.
First, I have to acknowledge the incredible student talent we've seen on the stage tonight. They're a testament to the importance of fighting to maintain the visual and performing arts in our schools. It's that creative spark and human touch that teachers inspire in their students. Now, with the tsunami of new education flooding our classrooms, we as teachers must also represent the human connection between student to student, student to the world, and student to the future. While the World Wide Web is the epitome of technology, teachers weave the World Wide Web of humanity. Now, let's meet the final nominees of the evening.
Sarah Matthews, San Diego County Office of Education.
Well, a lot of them have kind of a beaten down attitude towards school. They feel that they haven't fit in. So it's really kind of getting them to just believe in themselves. You know, we want to hear your voice. You have an important message. You have something to offer. And once they kind of start getting that energy, then they just sort of start blossoming. They want to learn more. So you really start seeing that drive come up.
Viana Rodriguez, Sweetwater.
Helping my students understand that they are a part of that, that learning history isn't something that just is in a textbook, you know, that happened long ago, that it's something that's continuous, something that they are a part of. And so they have to be a socially responsible and socially aware community member so that they can affect change. I always tell my students that, you know, ordinary people can do extraordinary things and that they should never doubt that.
Margarita Edos, San Diego.
I facilitate the class because I know my students can do it. I believe in them and I empower them. I teach them how to think and I motivate them by using fun activities that they're gonna remember throughout their life. They also learn about character education, learning about values, perseverance, determination, self-discipline, integrity, trust, you know, being trustworthy.
Eric Esperon, Sweetwater.
When you see those kids, like, oh, wow, this is what the Constitution means to us. Oh, this is why I have to pay more for that bag of Cheetos. I mean, just seeing their eyes open up is just the most awesome thing about it. They're not going to forget. I mean, they're going to forget our names, the students. But they never forget the ideas that they learn in our class, and that's one way to, you'll live forever. I mean, what other profession can you really say that in? I can't think of many.
And the 10th finalist for San Diego County Teacher of the Year is Sarah Matthews.
Sarah Matthews teaches science to 8th through 12th graders at Sarah Anthony School inside Juvenile Hall. She motivates her students to learn important lessons from their mistakes and inspires them to see their potential as contributors in society.
The first school that I really kind of developed a connection to was Tucson Academy, which serves homeless kids in San Diego downtown. And I had this amazing class of students, and I really wanted to be a part of helping these kids believe in themselves. And there's a lot of different programs that I've worked for. But right now, within Sarah Anthony, I teach an all-female population, and they can range in age from 12 to 18, and they are every type of student. One of the things I really work on with the girls is that, you know, there's choice, and then there's lessons that you can learn from your choices. So we talk a lot about that doesn't have to define you, the choices that you've made in your past. And that's what I try to bring to these girls is, you know, high expectations, quality work that's interesting to them, and really push them to inquire, ask questions, challenge the world, and the world wants to hear what they have to say. And once they believe it, it just kind of sets them free.
In the school that we teach at, the kids transition sometimes every day, every few days. And Sarah has the ability to form connections quickly with kids, and that's what you have to have. And Sarah celebrates the baby steps to the big steps, because it's all success.
Tucson is a place for kids who are like homeless or have no place to go. That's where we went. One of the main things that I learned from Ms. Sarah is no matter what you're going through, there's always something positive in it. There's always something to learn to make your life better.
These girls that I work with are like any girl in any school, and they've been through some challenges and some obstacles that most of us probably can't really imagine, and yet they still come to school and they smile and they're excited to learn and they ask questions and they want more. And that's what I would want people to know about them, is that they deserve to be recognized, they deserve to be acknowledged, and they're part of the future.
Wow. It really is an honor to receive this recognition and represent the San Diego County Office of Education. The juvenile court and community schools serve some pretty amazing students who have been through some really difficult challenges in their lives. And yet they still have perseverance and they still have that true grit to succeed, and it truly is an inspiration. So it's just a reminder to always reach out to the kids who might seem a little bit resistant or a little bit reluctant. Or even sometimes unreachable. And try to make that connection. Try to find that smile and that brilliance so that they can inspire you the way they inspire us. Thank you so much.
What have you learned today? Tune in for an all-new Salute to Education, where every month we show you all the cool, amazing, innovative, and inspirational stuff happening in San Diego schools.
All kinds of things.
Extraordinary teachers and students. Innovative programs in the arts, technology, sports, and science. What have you learned today? Salute to Education, all new on Channel 4 San Diego. Go to 4SD.com for more information.
Who will be named the new San Diego County Teachers of the Year? The winners will be announced next.
Education is a cornerstone of our community and the very foundation of our future. Soquan is extremely proud to be a longtime partner of Cox Presents, A Salute to Teachers. It is our way of demonstrating strong support and great appreciation for the leaders who've dedicated their lives to the education and enrichment of young people all across San Diego County. A heartfelt thanks from all of us at Soquan.
I think that we need to thank teachers more for the job that they're doing in our lives, because if we didn't have teachers, then we wouldn't go very far in our lives.
Teachers are definitely the unsung heroes of society. Oftentimes, they don't really get paid well. They don't get a lot of recognition, but they're what makes our education system go, because they get kids interested at a very crucial age in a lot of academic topics. So it's important to recognize them, to remind them and everyone in the community about how important they are.
Because they're just so amazing, and they have to wake up every single morning so early to prepare the classroom for their students.
Because they're teaching you, and they won't give up on you. They tell you to keep on trying, because if you do something bad, they forgive you and they give you more chances.
Oh yes, we need to thank them so much. We need to raise their paychecks and everything. They're just so awesome.
Because if we don't, then it's like, why be here? Because they do it for a reason, to help you out. And if you don't recognize them, then it's just like, they're just there for nothing.
Because they work really hard and they have to put up with us, especially during Halloween and the end of the school year. Because during Halloween, the kids will eat a ton of candy and they're all crazy. And during the end of the school year, everybody just wants it to be over, so.
I think that teachers are really shaping and molding the future of America. And not only that, but inspiring students to achieve what they really want to do. And so I think that that needs to be thanked time and time again.
I say we rally for the bigger paychecks. What do you think?
Right.
Yeah! Cindy Martin, can you get on that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Just a guess, that kid's gonna be a politician.
Yes.
Yeah. Anyway, we are at the most exciting part of our show.
That is right. We are about to find out which of the 10 fantastic finalists that we have met tonight are going to be named San Diego County Teachers of the Year.
Yep, it's time. Let's get to it. Cox Communications Senior Vice President and General Manager Dave Bialas is passionate about supporting educational programs for Southern California teachers and young people.
Through his direction, Cox Communications provides scholarships and classroom grants to students and schools, making Cox a leading corporate partner in education.
And his partner out here tonight, Dr. Randy Ward, began his career as a kindergarten teacher in his hometown of Boston, and his heart has never left the classroom.
He's a champion for all students and for the great work that our teachers do to help all of our children achieve.
All right, so let's give a big welcome to Cox Senior Vice President and General Manager Dave Bialas and County Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Randy Ward.
Good evening. On behalf of Cox Communications and all of our California employees, I want to congratulate all the teachers and the staff here tonight. We celebrate you because you do make a difference.
And Dave, I want to thank you and everyone at Cox for the way you've honored teachers for 24 straight years. No one does it like San Diego County does it.
It is a record we plan on keeping into the 25th year.
And 26th, and 27th, and 28th.
And beyond. You know, the cliche that there's five winners and we can't name enough is true. And I want to recognize that there are more than five winners. It is difficult naming five out of this illustrious group. So we thought it would be a good idea to recognize all the teachers in the audience, or even the retired teachers. If you would stand,
all
we
of
can
you.
Give you
stand
all of
up.
You.
Every teacher in the audience, stand up, please.
Wow.
Look at them up there.
We have five envelopes, but there truly are hundreds, if not thousands, of winners. The other couple of winners I want to talk about. What do you think of these videos? What if we didn't have these videos? It would really not make this evening. We have a couple people who spend a half a year, thousands of hours, Deborah and Carla, who you do not know. They produce this show. And I want to recognize them. This is a live show. It's a two-hour live show. You just don't see it anywhere in America. And they spend literally half a year doing those videos. So I want to thank them.
You know, there's so many teachers out here. There's so much energy in this room. I've often said to folks, don't ever underestimate the power of a great teacher. You change the lives of individual students, we've heard that. You change the trajectory of families, and you change the productivity of this great country. I want to thank you for that. I also want you to understand that great teachers, as Teacher Schifini said, are magical. They take responsibility for their children learning no matter what family they come from, no matter what their socioeconomic status is, no matter whether their dad or mom is an alcoholic or they don't have a dad or mom. They don't use that as a reason for children not learning. They take full responsibility every day, and that's why our teachers work so hard every day planning to make sure every teacher and every student is learning. So I want to thank you. Let's give yourselves a big applause.
I think there's a vendor right there. Want to?
Yep.
End it?
Yep.
Go right to it.
So what do you say we do this?
This is exciting. Not Price Waterhouse sealed. But again, five is not enough to recognize you all. So fortunately, we'll do the five, but please know you're all winners. And we admire you more than you know. Okay, are we ready? Let's find out. Our first San Diego Teacher of the Year is Maria Teron
Cruz. You know, Maria, you do eventually have to come up to the stage.
We'll bring Kleenex for you.
And the second San Diego County Teacher of the Year is Sarah Matthews. Woo!
Oh, boy. I've already got the chills. Okay, the third San Diego County Teacher of the Year is John Beret.
And the fourth County Superintendent of the Year. No, I'm not announcing myself, sorry. And the fourth San Diego County Teacher of the Year is Compet Pease.
Okay. She received the loudest ovation, so I can't imagine what this will sound like. But the fifth San Diego County Teacher of the Year is Mary Goins.
Thank you so much. Yes, go Mary. This is such a privilege. I never in a million years, a little girl from Nicaragua, come to the States and be in this place. I want to thank my mom and dad for never giving up on me and us for working so hard to bring us to where we are. But I want to tell you something. It takes a village to make a good teacher. And mine is amazing. My coworkers, my parents, my little ones, my principal, the janitor at school, they all make us who we are. And we need to work together to do what we do best, and that is take care of our children. Thank you so much for this honor. Thank you.
Good evening. I wanted to take the opportunity to thank all my friends and family as well, since I think I didn't do that the last time. This really is such an honor, and so many students' faces and stories are running through my mind right now. Oftentimes we work with the kids in juvenile court and community schools that sort of fall through the cracks. So to have been a part, a small part of their journey or a piece of their success is an amazing thing to be a part of. And I'd like to put some acknowledgement to my juvenile court and community school teachers who work every day to show up to make education accessible to all kids. Thank you.
Such a tremendous honor. My heart's beating. My phone is vibrating with my pocket. And I don't know how to keep it all straight. I'd like to thank Jennifer North Morris, who couldn't be here tonight, but she was my mentor teacher way back in the day. And she empowered me with the ability to risk. And that's what our schools need, is we need risk takers who are willing to challenge the status quo. Special shout out to my Five Guys crew. You know who you are, who do the same. They help me challenge the status quo. My family and friends who are here tonight and who are watching from TV, especially my mom who's at home. This one's for you, Mom. I love you. And the UCSD Noise Master Teacher Fellowship under the directorship of Chris Halter, which is the perfect playground for teachers like me. Thank you very much.
One of the first person I'd like to thank is my colleague Rubiat Kibria. Sorry, I mispronounced your name. But he's actually the reason why I'm even up here, because he basically forced me and made me promise him that I would apply, because I was so reluctant to apply. And so if it wasn't for him cajoling me and coaxing me to apply, I would not be up here. So thank you, Rubiat, for that nudge. When I first decided I wanted to become a teacher, I remember telling my family and friends, and their initial reaction was not very positive. And I remember when I first got my job at Wilson Middle School, the reaction likewise was not very positive. People told me it was going to be challenging and that I probably wouldn't last, but I'm happy to say that I did. And I love teaching, and I love my job and my kids, and I know I made the right choice. Thank you very much.
I think it's going to be a long evening. I'm glad I wore comfortable shoes. It's just been an incredible ride. When my superintendent first recognized me at a staff meeting as an accomplished teacher, I knew I was an accomplished teacher, but I didn't know I was Teacher of the Year quality. And so this has just been like, kind of like Frog's wild ride or Toad's wild ride, but it's been such a learning experience for me. And it's just another, I couldn't have done it without all the support that I've had, my family, my staff, my administration. And again, another big shout out to my mom. She neither could be here tonight. And Nancy and my sisters, Nancy and Carol, and they've supported me all the way through. And it's just, if you know anyone who wants to be a teacher, encourage them. It's an incredible, incredible love. Thank you.
Oh,
How about an extra round of applause for Mary's pencil skirt, most creative dress of the night. Yeah.
Let's give them a big round of applause, your brand new San Diego County Teachers of the Year.
Good night, everybody. See you next year.